Follow all Moessieurs news on his website, www.moessieurs.com, and on his Facebook Moessieurs and Instagram Moessieurs 13 page 2, for daily exclusive publications.
Hi dear Moessieurs followers, and welcome for that new Moessieurs Monday video dedicated to the Montage M, and the today topic is about the MIDI management and the things I appreciate and find useful to use it on stage and also in home studio. Sit all along the video, because on the bonus I'm going to explain to you an easy and quick way to find what controller do inside each of your performance. But just before to start, if you are not already a Moessieurs YouTube follower, please click on subscribe and also click on the bell if you do not want to miss my upcoming video. If you like the video content, please click on like, that's very important for the channel. And also, if you want to support me, you can use bottom right the video, the super thanks, it's like a kind of donation, or for a monthly fee, less than €3, you can become a Moessieurs community member. You will have dedicated private video for members. You will have all the video I release in preview more than 4 weeks, rather to the other's followers. And if you book a Moessieurs masterclass with me, you will have 15 minutes extended time.
To explain to you the Montage M MIDI management, and also the differences with the Montage first generation, the ModX or ModX Plus, and the features that I particularly appreciate for stage using, I took this performance, which come from Easy Sound's Spectral Move version 2 sound bank. Originally it had parts 1 and 2, I work on it and added 2 presets pad, and finally, I set these 4 parts under keyboard control. On the Montage first generation, the ModX or ModX Plus, when you have all these parts with keyboard control set to on, if you play with the multi-mode, each part play in layer but receives and transmits on its reference MIDI channel. I choose the display mode where you see the MIDI channels. For part 1 we see 1. Part 2 we see 2. Part 3 we see 3. Part 4 we see 4. You might think by viewing this that it worked in the same way. No, it's not the same thing, because on the Montage M, there are no longer the modes we had on the Montage first generation, the ModX, or ModX Plus. There's no more multi-mode, or hybrid mode, or single mode. There's just one way to work. Let's go to Utility. Then go to Settings. Select MIDI EO, and choose the MIDI channel which you want your keyboard control to receive and send. Those with the little green pad lit up. Even if the top display indicate channel 1, channel 2, channel 3, channel 4, on the Montage M, these 4 parts receive and transmit on the same MIDI channel. This is very practical on stage, because on my right, you can't see it, I've got my Arturia Keylab Mk3 keyboard control, which is a single MIDI channel keyboard that send on a single MIDI channel. Like here, my 4 parts under keyboard control play on a single MIDI channel, which is MIDI channel 1 I've defined, I've set the same on the Keylab. I'm perfectly capable of playing what I've got here from my Arturia Keylab. You'll be thinking, they've just set the hybrid mode on the Montage M, because I've chosen a MIDI channel like when it was in hybrid mode, and I can play the 4 parts on keyboard control from another keyboard connected to a single MIDI channel. This is super practical on stage, because you don't need to have a control keyboard with several zones, and often they're limited to 4, so we were limited to 4 parts to play on multi-mode. I can set 8 parts and play them from the Arturia with no worries at all. But, it's not exactly like the hybrid mode, you'll see, it's much better than that, because now we're going to move on to the second video part. Take in count that supply for internal parts, because you'll see that we also have external parts that can be under keyboard control or not. Let's try some things. If I select my parts 3 and 4, and I remove the keyboard control, what happens when playing from my Montage M keyboard? When I'm on common, or if I select one of the two parts that are on keyboard control, the 1 and 2, I only play the parts that are under keyboard control. To play part 3 or part 4 from my Montage M keyboard, I need to select one of them. For example here, if I select part 3, I'll only be able to play part 3. And if I select part 4 as you have seen, I only play part 4 from the Montage M keyboard. Okay, let's try something else, like we have access to these MIDI channel settings. What happens if I set these two parts, on the same MIDI channel, different from the channel I've chosen in utility of course. From my Montage M keyboard, it's the same thing, I can only play by selecting one of them, part 3 or part 4 alone. It's not because I've set them on the same MIDI channel, that I can play them together from the Montage M keyboard. But what happens if I play from my Arturia Keylab, if I set them to play on MIDI channel 2? There I can play my two parts in layer from a connected external keyboard, the two parts playing together in layer are split with a simple MIDI 5-pin DIN connection, without any software like Camelot Pro, or any DAW like Cubase. This is impossible to do this, with a Montage first generation, a Modex, a Modex Plus. I find it particularly appreciable on stage, I could play the first two parts under keyboard control or more, if I wanted from my Montage M. And in the same time, I can make super layers too, with 2, 3, 4 or more parts without keyboard control, which I can play from my other 5-pin DIN connected keyboard, like my Arturia Keylab in a very simple way. While we're on this new Montage M view, let's see another interesting point, when you want to change octave part tone, up or down. With a first generation Montage, Modex, Modex Plus, you can do this by going to Edit Part, Pitch and Note Shift. Plus or minus 24. That's the limit through the note shift here with two octaves, so you have to enter these screens to do it. Or there's the trick of switching to the zone settings screen. And here we have the octave shift that allows us to make plus or minus 3 octaves, but one more time, you have to enter into the edit screens. You don't need to go into the screens with the Montage M. You just select that display mode, for example, and there I can change 2 or 3 octaves. Just to show you, I go back to master mode, you'll see that the minus 2 value is there. It's exactly the same for transpose, which is right next to it here. It transposes, in fact, just like in the master zone settings. But here you don't have to go into the screens at all, you do it directly from the home screen, very useful for rehearsals, or even on stage, to make a quick change on the fly. It works for parts with or without keyboard control without any problem. It's great to have this on the Montage M. I've switched to utility, with USB connection, because now we're going to see the last point that's been added, and which I also really appreciate. This is the external management. On the Montage first generation, Modex, Modex Plus, when you wanted to add a part, but use it to control a rack, another keyboard or a virtual instrument on a computer or tablet, you added the part. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take the first one that comes up, because here, you'll see, it really doesn't matter. You had to go to edit, still in zone settings, and you had an internal switch slot. You had to unactivate that slot. On Montage M, it's not internal, it's external that you choose, but on Montage M, you don't need to go into the edit screens to do that. I'm simply adding a control part, for a virtual instrument, a rack, one other keyboard. We just have to do this. Click twice quickly on the part button. You'll see that it changes color, now it's set in external mode. If I go back to the screen we have seen earlier, you'll see that it's changed to external. Let's change the video view, with the Arturia Analog Lab Pro, to add some pretty nice sounds with the Montgomery birds, for example, to give to that performance a little more chill ambience. Here I'm going to play directly from the Montage M keyboard. So you've heard the lovely bird sounds added under keyboard control, my four parts playing in layer with the VST instrument. I set this Analog Pro Pad on MIDI channel 5 for reception in its settings, but I'm under keyboard control. I explained before that, parts under keyboard control plays only on MIDI channel 1 in my example. Absolutely not for external parts. I'm just going to show you. I'm going to disable keyboard control for parts 1 to 4. I'll be able to play my pad alone with keyboard control set on. Even it's under keyboard control, it doesn't respond to the MIDI channel you've defined in utility. It's under its own MIDI channel because it's an external part. Pay close attention to this. Here it was in part 5. By default it's MIDI channel 5. I could set it to 2. If I wanted, I could change it, since all the others are on MIDI channel 1, as I had set them under keyboard control like this. Here you have to set a different MIDI channel, obviously in Analog Lab. I've set MIDI channel 5 reception for this video example, because I'm in external. That's also something I appreciate. This double tap functionality here, to set directly a part as external. It's extremely practical. It doesn't look like. It's very simple. It saves us going into menus. On the other hand, if you go back to edit part, earlier we were in the settings area, but here on our internal parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, you can see that the whole bottom part, you don't see anything. You don't see bank select, MSB, LSB, that sort of thing. You only see it on external parts. This means that if you simply want to send MIDI MSB LSB PC command to another keyboard connected to your Montage M, you'll need to activate an external part, which will do just that. External part is used for this purpose. This is not a problem for me on stage, because I don't usually exceed 5 or 6 parts per performance, but be careful. You need to think about integrating an external part if you're in that situation. You don't want to control that sound from your Montage M keyboard. But simply send the MIDI command to play it from its keyboard.
Would you like to take in hand, learn or improve your knowledge of your Yamaha synthesizer or stage keyboard? Book your Moessieurs Masterclass now. Your private session is conducted online through Zoom. Take all benefit of Joel's expertise for all these topics. It's available for users all over the world through Music Hackspace platform in English or in French. It's easy. Select your date and time from the Moessieurs calendar available slots on your time zone, Choose your topic and after your online personal meeting, you can download your session video to review it, as many anytime you need. And now, that's the bonus time.
For this bonus, I told you that we were going to see how easily we could find out what a controller do. If you don't want to navigate into the screens, a little in the idea of everything I've done throughout this video, there's a fairly simple feature. I'm going to choose my part 1, for example. I'm going to press Shift, I hold it, and in the same time, I press Control Assign, which bring us to the Control View selection screen. All I have to do is move a controller. It could be my super knob. It could be my rotary knobs. Let's do it with the mod wheel, and then we'll see that our part 1, the one that's not blinking, which is selected, has several destinations under control, which you can see on the screen. I can of course juggle, switch to another part like that, depending on when I move my scroll wheel, if I want to know what it does, if I want to change the values, I have here a direct access. The first idea was not to go into the screens, but now that we're on this screen, if you want to do it with another controller, just click here on auto select, and now, selecting my part 2, moving this assignable knob, here it show me it's the cutoff. The 2 is resonance and volume. The 3 is cutoff envelope generator. You see lots of controls on this part of the Easy Sounds spectral move bank.
This is video ending. I hope you have liked it. I hope you have find it interesting. As a reminder, you can book your Moessieurs Masterclass directly on the Music Arcspace platform. See you soon for one of our Moessieurs video. Bye.
Would you like to discover, learn, or improve your knowledge of your Yamaha synthesizer or stage keyboard? Book your Moessieurs Masterclass now. Your private session is conducted online through Zoom. Take all benefit of Moessieurs' expertise, Yamaha synthesizers, and stage keyboard specialist and consultant for Yamaha Music Europe and France. As member of International Yamaha Tech Talk Live Team, Music Hackspace instructor, and host of the Camelot Pro Sessions, Joel take care of your experience level. Whether you're a beginner or a skilled user, get the most out of your Yamaha synthesizer, stage keyboard, John Mayla's software suite, or Camelot Pro. Book your session for your personal Moessieurs one-to-one session. It's available for users all over the world through Music Hackspace platform. It's easy. Select your date and time from the Moessieurs calendar available slots on your time zone. Thank you for watching this Moessieurs video. Do not forget to click on like, subscribe and click on the bell to be informed when a new video is online. Do not hesitate to write a comment or ask a question. See you soon, bye!